Hello everyone, and welcome to another Applied Energistics 2 video. In this one, I will talk about this crazy and awesome ME controller. It's a 7-cubed, that means 7x7x7 ME controller multi-block. Everything is connected to each other, and we have lots of channels coming out of it. Let's see, it was 22,816 if I've done the math and build correctly. So actually at the moment this is the highest number I've seen on a single ME controller. But I might have missed something, might change a block or two to find a few more channels. Well, I'm not gonna do it. I spent too many hours on this already. So let's go over how it works and how I have connected everything. The bottom layer looks like this. It's the foundation for a pillar system. And the reason for doing this is not a mistake. It's because we have to connect the center pillars somehow. And if I do like this, it's not working because you can't connect it in four direction at the same time or something like that. So now we have only two more to go. Actually three more, because when we connect it like this and have this block put on top, it's not connected yet. So then when we go up here to the top layer, I have connected it slightly different. You can see here that we have still those three not connected, but if you do like this, than they are. And I can't have one in the middle for the same reason as before. So in total there are 188 controller blocks, and since we have pillars, that means that we have lots of space inside. Now if I connect just, let's take it over here, like this, P2P tunnels, like this, and then we set a cable coming out like this, then we have 8 channels coming out, so this is the maximum. We can't reach further inside than 2 blocks. That's why we have to fill all the interior blocks below 2 blocks and above 2 blocks from here. So we have to fill those with as many P2P tunnels as we can, and I will go through it slightly more detailed over there. But just so you know, they are filled with tunnels and cables already. So there are an interior part and an exterior part. So if we go through the math quickly, then we have on the inside, perhaps you had time to see it, we have 135 P2P tunnels connected. And that means that we are getting 4,320 channels from the inside of the pillars. They are coming out through these purple ones. And since there are 135, we need 5 sides to extract them. 4 times 32 is 128. So you need slightly more than 4 sides to extract them. But it's still worth it to sacrifice these sides to be just a P2P tunnel, perhaps I can say. And then we have the exterior part, where we have in total 578 P2P connections. And on the outside, everything is as I did the top 2 blocks in the pillars. They are connected to as many P2P tunnels as I can, and then connected to dense cables. So here are 24 and 31 and 16, 31, 31, and so on. So all these ME controller blocks out here are supposed to be like a backbone system. If you remember this video, if you have seen it, then we have ME controller over there. We have a backbone of just containing P2P tunnels, and then extracting 32 channels in each and every room. So that's how it's supposed to be done over here as well. For all of these coming out, so here we can fill 31 dense cables coming out. And if we sum those figures, 578 on the outside, that means 18,496 channels on the exterior part, and in total 23,000 almost. So it's very hard to demonstrate or show close by, because when you start to build this from the inside out, it gets very crowded. And since it's not perfectly symmetrical, that also adds to the, it's slightly trickier to, well, to draw the cables, because to some extent you can be completely symmetrical, as I've done on this side. But then on the bottom side and the top side, you have to be, well, somewhat creative, I guess. So this is how it looks. Tons of P2P tunnels, tons of cables, thin cables, dense cables, coming out in every direction. And it's powered over here. Since these are connected to the MA controller, we can power it from here. And then all these has to be powered in some other way. Well, you do probably quartz fiber and connect different nets, but that's how it's supposed to look anyway. So how does this work if we go in detail? Well, there are basically three ways to extract channels from the ME controller in a build like this. Either you can do it like this, connect a dense cable or a thinner one, but you probably want all the 32 channels to a side, and then split it into thinner ones, and then you have your storage system, perhaps cables and stuff. So that's the most common way. And then you can do it like this. It's the same thing. So we have P2P tunnel here, 1, 2, 3, and 4 coming out, and four of these coming, well, connected to those. And all of these are part of the same network. Since we have only four, we don't need any ME controller in the middle, and as I do up here. No, where was it? Over here. Here we need a controller and a power as well, but we don't need that over here. Just some power, no controller. And then we have the special solution that I made in the interior parts. If we remove this one and this one, then you can see that down there we have five tunnels within the same block space. It's the top of this one, and then the four surrounding ones. So we have five there, and then we have these three. And all of these must be synced using the memory card. Sync, load the settings, save the settings for this one, and load it to some other one. And this is the tricky part. You don't want to do this and like I did here. It's very hard to maintain a good structure, since when I built it like this, it's very hard to reach down there, and also very hard to remember what tunnel goes to what, since you can only do one at a time. But all of these eight in here are connected to this side on the interior part, and they're coming out here as well, like here, eight coming out to eight tunnels. And all of these are, of course, connected to the same network. So when you continue to grow it like this, then I just did the same thing again. Connect three of those into one side, and then I think I could connect eight to come out on the top or bottom or a side. So when you master these techniques, then basically you just do it over and over and over again and spend so many hours on it until you're done. But in the end, you will get an awesome controller. It's pretty extreme, but it's fun to explore the theory behind applied energistics. So if you have any questions or a comment, a positive one, I hope, then just leave it in the comment section and tell me what you think. All right, that's it. Thanks for watching. See you in the next one. Take care. Bye-bye.